In this video, I'm going to explain the usage of 5 JFR tools and share 2 short cases studies at the end. Let's start with the first tool. Draw on an object. Create a sphere. Select on a sphere. With it, we can draw curves on the surface of any object. We will use it a lot in our work. Close here is like any other curve tool. It's a toggle that closes and opens the curve. When pull is no, only the control points fit on the surface. And the curve is hidden inside. Right-click to re-edit. Generally, I prefer to turn on pull so that the curve fits better on the surface. If it doesn't fit partially, it's because there aren't enough control points. Just add more control points at this position. That's better. When you learn JFR's rail tool, you can combine them to quickly make some ribbons that fit the surface. Let me give you an example. It's very convenient. In addition to working on a single surface, poly surfaces can also create a cube. Draw directly on the surface. Double-click twice to create a right angle. Let's move on to the Draw on All Objects tool. Create a mesh sphere. We should know that Draw on an Object can only draw curves on an object. The advantage is that when there is an object blocking the view, it will not be affected by it. You can just ignore it. Draw on All Objects allows you to draw curves across multiple surfaces at the same time. It supports all object types, including single surfaces, poly surfaces, and meshes, etc. However, that it fits to the control points of the curve. Moving on to the next tool. Let's learn how to use ring size. This is a quick way to create a standard ring size circle. The value in the upper left corner refers to the diameter of the circle. The right side controls the position of the generated seam points. The most commonly used option is bottom. This means aligned to the current work plane. When I'm in top view, with this option turned on, the circle line is generated in top view. When I close it, it reverts back to the front view by default. Here you can change the number of control points for the generated curve. Of course, it is recommended to use 16 control points to make sure the shape of the circle is accurate enough. On the left, you can choose from a variety of local standards. For example, select Hong Kong. On the right, select a size number. By generating ring size circles in this way, you can reduce a lot of repetitive operations while working. There are also customized dimensions. Just enter the value you want. Next tool, offset curve. Select a curve. Offset it directly. The resulting curve has the same number of control points. This is the switch to the sides of the offset. Here you can enter a value for a precise offset. It's very easy to use. Let's move on to the next tool. Offset curve normal to surface. Create a sphere. Then draw a random curve on the sphere. It offsets the curve normal to the object. The resulting surface is perpendicular to the sphere. Left-click to generate. Let's look at the options in the command prompt. This controls the offset distance. This is the toggle for the sides of the offset. It's obscured by the surface, so we can't see it. We have to switch to Ghosted to see them. Some of the tools we use can't be toggled on and off by shortcut keys, so we'll just change it here. Modify the offset in both directions here. Left-click to confirm generation. If I just want to offset the curve, it can certainly do that as well. Toggle this option. Change the direction. The resulting curve can be used for rail forming. Next, I will demonstrate these tools with two short case studies. Sometimes I need to automate the setting of stones on the surface of a pedal. Then I need to split the surface. By using the offset curve normal to surface, the split will be more accurate. Now, I'll do a quick demo. First, I draw a curve on the mesh for the split. Adjust it a little bit. Then I use this curve to split the surface of the mesh. If you use the curve directly, you'll probably get the wrong split surface. The top and bottom mesh surfaces are connected. So we need to offset the curve into a surface. Click to generate. And then we'll use the surface to split the mesh. The edges of the split mesh will be very nice. That's what I want. Now I can use Auto Pave Gem directly. I'm going to explain in detail how to use Auto Pave Gem in a future video. For now, I'm just going to show you how it works. Let's move on to the next case. Combining some of the previously learned tools. It's pretty easy to make a style like this. First, create a circle. Select a curve and create a pipe. Open Grasshopper. In CAD JFR, take the pebble pattern. Set the surface into it. Adjust the spacing of the pattern. Randomize the pattern. Then take out the bait group. Connect them and click the button to create. Offset the pipe inwards. Flip all. Distance 0.4. Select curve. Offset curve normal to surface. Select the fitting surface. Offset surfaces over 0.4 are sufficient. It is best to select all surfaces at once and group them together. Boolean off the surfaces with the pipe inside. Then use the resulting object to subtract the pipe. Hide the curves. Finally, fillet edge the object. A radius value of 0.1 is sufficient. That's it. That's all there is to this video. If this video is helpful to you, please like, share this video, and subscribe to us. See you next time.